What is up, YouTube? It's your boy ChasmRift here, and it's been a while, but here I am today giving you guys a video. I kind of wanted to just do like a weekly recap type of video because there was so much that happened in the world that I feel like it's interesting for you guys and interesting for me, and I kind of just want to get my thoughts on it all instead of making separate videos. None of this is going to be in order. I'm just going to go based on what I think is relevant and, you know, stick with it. Trust me, I got some bangers in this one. So first things first, shout out to ESG. We did our thing in this Pokemon Unite League that we're a part of, for those who didn't know. We battled against a team called the Toronto Talon Flames, and we successfully won 2-0. So shout out to my team, shout out to my teammates. You know, you guys did your thing, and hopefully we should be able to win the league. We got a wave of momentum on our side, and we're not letting it go to our heads. We're still taking things seriously. We're still, you know, collecting data, watching film, so etc. So yeah, be sure to cheer us on whenever we do matches. Maybe I'll upload videos on here to let people know, like, hey, got a match coming up if you guys are interested in that. Then that, second topic. We had the Pokemon Present earlier this week, and first things first, Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl, they look promising. They're pretty good. I'm glad to see that they're not a complete carbon copy of the originals. They got their own little flavor and things like that with the contest being revamped. We got, you know, Pokemon, the underground tunnels, they're being revamped. They got different modes and features. I'm happy to see that. Now, for me personally, when it comes to playing a Sinnoh game, outside of Platinum, Sinnoh is not my favorite place to play it, region-wise. I just didn't like the pacing of Diamond and Pearl, but that could easily change with this being played on the Switch, because playing Pokemon with a controller, that is OD. It is game-changing, no pun intended. Secondly, Legends Arceus looks phenomenal. Like, this game looks beautiful. I love the story and the lore that's going on. I love that we have new evolutions for the likes of Basculin, for the likes of Stantler. We got Hisuian forms for Braviary, and we also got them for Growlithe. Like, I'm hyped for the game. I'm hyped that we could actually be attacked by the Pokemon in the wild, and everything just looks promising. And like I said, we're gonna pull up on anybody who hates on this game before it drops. Now, in the past, you know, you guys see me, you know, get irritated and whatnot whenever I saw people get mad and complain about Sword and Shield because of, you know, whether it be the national decks or all this other stuff. And you know what? It feels like a general complaint. I understand. Again, just irritated to see people, you know, cry so much on social media. But I understood if you actually had your rights about Sword and Shield. This game, however, people are really grasping straws, in my opinion, because now all of a sudden people don't want to see regional variants. They think they're outplayed. They think that they're not cool anymore. People are complaining about the lore of the game and how this is like a carbon copy of Breath of the Wild, etc. It's like, it's one thing to be mad about something that's actually understandable. It's another thing to just complain and not be satisfied with anything. And this game just proves that some people just won't ever be satisfied. It's unfortunate, but it's the reality. Moving on to the next thing I got on this list, VGC is going to be stuck to Sword and Shield. Now, I'm actually fine with this. I anticipated this was going to happen. It's funny to me that a lot of people didn't know that Legend of Arceus was actually a single-player game. There's confirmation if you go through the eShop now. But there's a rumor or theory that maybe Brilliant Diamond, Shining Pearl will be like a legacy format, or maybe they'll have newer Pokemon in the game, and that will be for the VGC circuit. But I figured it'd be Sword and Shield. I'm kind of glad that it is. And my theory is, instead of us getting more DLC for Sword and Shield, hopefully they'll do an update after Brilliant Diamond, Shining Pearl, and Legends Arceus drop, where those Pokemon that aren't in the Sword and Shield Pokédex can be sent over, and they'll be compatible with Sword and Shield via a big update, because these games are all compatible with home. I think that would make a lot of sense to have them be compatible with one another in terms of transferring. That's just my theory. If it doesn't happen, I won't be too mad, but yeah, I just wanted to put that out there. Next thing on the list is Pokemon Unite announced and dropped Blissey. Then, at the Pokemon Presents, they announced Mamoswine and Sylveon were going to be revealed and added to the game. My question is, where is Blastoise? Blastoise was announced along with Gardevoir as future Pokemon to be dropped in this game. Yet, Gardevoir was released first. Even though all the promotion, Blastoise was shown first before Gardevoir, as well as Blissey not only being announced, but put in the game first. And now we got Mamoswine and Sylveon, who may drop before Blastoise. My question is, where is he? I don't care if he's intended to be for the mobile version of the game to drop, because they could have announced it here at the Presents. I'm sorry, they really could have. They announced the Hollow War for Pikachu and whatnot, and they announced all this other stuff that's going to be happening for the mobile version. Maybe they already got Blastoise in the game. They could announce that along with the regular Pokemon Unite news. I'm just kind of irritated because they always shaft Blastoise and the whole Squirtle line for a lot of this stuff. We all know Blastoise is still loved. Next, Halo Infinite won't release with campaign co-op on launch. I'm disappointed, especially since I plan on playing Halo with some friends, playing through the story, through co-op, you know, through the Master Chief Collection, or just on PC. And I was hoping that, hey, if we can knock out these Halo games together before Infinite drops, that'd be pretty cool, and then we can play Infinite with co-op campaign. The fact that it's not dropping on launch, it's disappointing. I believe they're having a Battle Royale or some type of free mode that is coming out of Infinite. It makes me sad to see that those type of modes take priority over the core gameplay of games. Halo's known for their co-op and they're known for their multiplayer. And to see like some Battle Royale comes in, and I don't know if it definitely is the reason why there won't be a co-op on launch, but to see that the resources are being prioritized there, just unfortunate. We're seeing it with Call of Duty, we're seeing it with Battlefield to a degree, we're just seeing it with a bunch of games where their Battle Royale is taking more precedent, or just their free to play modes are taking more precedent than the actual content that made the game what it is today. Soulja Boy and Atari. So for those who didn't know, it was a big debacle on social media the other day. Soulja Boy announced on an Instagram live video, I believe, that he signed a deal with Atari, he's the CEO and all this, and that he's selling the Soulja game for $140 million, and that Atari was proud of him for what he did with Soulja game, and now he's the CEO. He even put it in his Twitter bio that he's the CEO of Atari. Atari, on the other hand, came out and said that, yeah, no, he's not the CEO. And then Soulja Boy came out and lashed out on Atari, revealing his contract, and telling them that, like, yeah, they should never come knocking on the door again, they better not use his name for anything, yada yada yada, using a bunch of potty mouth words. It was a big debacle. It was kind of funny to watch. It really made Soulja Boy kind of look bad because it just shows that he's a liar to the general public. I think it's just sad that there are people who rather believe Soulja Boy than actual Atari, but it just shows the power of the internet and how stupid people can say stupid things on social media and not get corrected for it. As for the actual contract, apparently it's a deal about their new Atari, like, cryptocurrency coin or whatever, and they're trying to work with Soulja Boy to, you know, promote it. And somehow he interpreted that as being the CEO or the owner of Atari. He said both. It shows that there was a flaw in his story when he first announced this. But regardless, we don't know if this is him doing this for clout or if he was really that dumb and didn't realize that they were just trying to partner with them. But regardless, this happened. It was kind of funny. And yeah, I just don't know how to really go off of that. It was just a funny time to see on the internet. And then finally, OnlyFans is banning sexual content.
Sensational.
So this is probably the highlight of the week. You saw a lot of funny memes talking about the OnlyFans girls are going to be working at McDonald's. I was quoting J. Crowell when he said that you can't be caught mopping at Wendy's. You saw a lot of people just having a field day on the social media. And then all of a sudden, the OnlyFans content creators, they started trying to clap back at people, talking about like, oh, you guys are basement dwellers. You guys live in your mom's basement. You guys don't even have real jobs. Yada, yada, yada. Trying to call out Twitch streamers as well and whatnot. And then others talking about like how, oh, I make more money on Snapchat than I do on OnlyFans. Well, to answer all this stuff, my big question is, if you're making more money on Snapchat, how come all y'all be promoting these OnlyFans content? If Snapchat's getting you more money, why not stick to the Snap instead of OnlyFans? Economically, if you already knew that one is better financially, why is that not the top priority? Secondly, why are y'all getting offended if that's the case? You guys got different avenues, you got degrees, you got different platforms you could work on. Why you gotta feel the need to clap back at people making funny on social media? Third, all these top 0.1% of OnlyFans accounts. I'm sorry, but if you guys are all in the top 0.1%, which we don't know how that's possible, unless they're lying, but we'll say, hey, you guys are in the top 1%. Maybe you guys would save the 6 and 7 figures of money y'all made, and you know, this wouldn't hurt you as much. Another one is, if you guys are so offended, why haven't you had a second stream of revenue? Not that some, it's not that hard to get other forms. For example, I do YouTube and Twitch. These aren't my jobs, but I can make content on either platforms depending on what I want to make. For this OnlyFans debacle, what you're talking about, if you're on here getting pounded on camera, that's being banned. If you're still just taking pics of you in a cosplay or whatever, that's fine. If you're doing that, you shouldn't even be lashing out against anybody on here. Regardless, if you do both, make content of the sexual nature and you're just posting lewd pics, you can still do OnlyFans and you can, you know, do Patreon and all this other stuff. But I don't know. It just shows, again, that some of these people who are cashing out and living on recruit difficulty, they aren't the brightest tools in the shiz. Otherwise, they wouldn't have felt the need to, you know, come out here and get mad at us. And finally, if we're making fun of y'all, we're vicariously making fun of, you know, those simps and all those sad individuals who are dumping thousands of dollars into your content. Like for me and the boys, if you asked us, hey, you can either buy an Xbox Series X, a PS5, a new graphics card, or spend money on an OnlyFans account, you best believe we're all going to be booting up and playing whatever game has crossplay, because we're going to be buying them consoles or the new GPU and gaming together.
It's cool, man. Got red bottoms on. Life is good. You know what I mean?
That's just us. On the other hand, there are dudes who they rather see random thotty 69 in a bikini instead of, you know, gaming on the new PS5. But, you know, more power to them, I guess. And that's the end of this recap. Thank everybody for watching this. Let me know what was your favorite thing that happened this past week. Let me know how you feel about the Pokemon news, how you feel about the Soulja Boy debacle, Halo, OnlyFans, and all that. Other than that, I'm about to get out of here. So peace out and bye. And don't forget to check out Dubby, our sponsor. Use code EvilScheme for 10% off of all purchases. The links will be down below. Other than that, I'm about to get out of here. Bye.